Hi, welcome to another Tigerfish tutorial. My name is Cord Elsner and today I want to show you how to create realistic tattoos in Photoshop. So let's get started. For this tutorial you need two files at hand. And first of all you need a photo of the subject you want to use the tattoo on, like this one here. And next you want a black and white image of your tattoo, like this dragon here. If you want to follow along with me, you can download this image of a bodybuilder arm from my website using this link here. And for the tattoo, this one, you can download this black and white design of a dragon from this web address right here. In this tutorial, we want to wrap this tattoo around the biceps of the bodybuilder. So first of all we need to make a selection to make sure that the tattoo is confined to this area. We make a selection by using the quick selection tool, and you can press W on your keyboard to select this tool, or you can click on the tool in the toolbar. Next we select the area of the arm like so. If you press the Alt key and press on this area, you can subtract from your selection. And if this tool didn't select everything you want, you can zoom in and press on these areas like so. It's really a quick selection. So if you want to refine the edge of your selection, you can go to the options bar here and press refine edge. And there, for my purpose, I take the radius up to 3 pixels and smooth the edge with a value of 20 pixels. And now I want to save my selection to a new alpha channel. I go up to the select select menu and choose save selection. I want a new alpha channel in my document I'm working in, and I choose for the name tattoo alpha. And you can see here in the channels panel, if I hit OK, I create a new alpha channel. Okay, back to the layers panel. Now I press Control D or Command D on the Mac to deselect my selection, and the next step is to create a displacement map. And the displacement map wraps the tattoo around the contours of the arm, like this vein here. And this displacement map is based on the shadows, midtones and highlights. So first we duplicate this image by going to Image Duplicate. I name this displacement map, hit OK, and now Photoshop creates a new file for me which is called displacement map. The displacement map works best if you slightly blur the image. So you go up to Filter, Blur and choose Gaussian Blur, and here we work with a value of 3 pixels, hit OK. And you get this blurred image. Next we want to desaturate our image. You go up to Image Adjustments and choose Desaturate, and you get this grayscale image. And in the next step we want to raise the contrast of the picture. We do this by choosing choosing this adjustment layer levels up here in the adjustments panel, and we pull this slider up a little bit and we pull this slider down a little bit. So we darken the shadow areas and we lighten the highlight areas. And in the next step I flatten the image because the displacement map needs a flat image, and I save this as displacement map PSD, that's okay, as a Photoshop file, and choose save. So now open up your dragon tattoo. this black and white tattoo file, and you convert the background layer to a layer by clicking on, double clicking on this background layer, and you change your tool to the magic wand tool. And for the tolerance, you use a value of 80. Only anti-alias is checked, not contiguous, and also not sample all layers. And you just click into the white area and press delete on your keyboard. And then you press Control D or Command D on a Mac to deselect your selection. So next you change to the Move tool by pressing V on your keyboard, and you click on this file here and drag it over to the image where you have your bodybuilder. And now you want to scale and rotate the image, so you press Control T or Command T on your keyboard. Go up to this corner here and press the Shift key on your keyboard, and you can scale the dragon. So I think I scale it to a size like this, or maybe a little bit smaller, and rotate it. Oops. Rotate it position it like here. If I'm satisfied with the angle size and position, you press enter on your keyboard. So next we blur this tattoo so it can blend better with the skin. Go up to filter, blur, Gaussian blur, and here I choose a radius of 1 pixel. Press OK. Then we want to use the displacement map to wrap the tattoo around the contours of the arm. Go to filter, distort, displace. Here you use horizontal scale and vertical scale 10, and leave stretch to fit and repeat edge pixels untouched. Hit OK. And here you choose the displacement map, and you can see that the shape adjusts itself by the tonal values of the arm. If I press Ctrl Z and Ctrl Z again, you see how the dragon is folded over the arm. So next we want to mask the parts of the tattoo which extend outside the arm, like these areas here. And you do this by control clicking on the tattoo, on the tattoo layer, and then you change to the channels panel, and here you press Control Shift Alt and click on the alpha channel, and you delete the selection outside the selection of the mask area and the alpha channel. You go back to the layers panel, activate the tattoo layer by clicking on it, and then you select add layer mask, and you can see the tattoo outside the arm is removed. Okay, next you go up to the blend modes and you change the blend mode to soft light. Sometimes the blend mode is also multiply. Yeah, you can choose what you want. Afterwards you press Control Shift Alt E or Command Shift Option E on a Mac to merge everything you created to a new layer. This is a snapshot of your composition, so to speak. Then you copy this layer by pressing Control J or Command J on your keyboard, and then you press on the layer with the layer mask and press Alt and drag your layer mask to this layer here to the new created layer, and you can see what you have done. If you deselect all layers, this is the layer you created by pressing Control Shift Alt E, and this is the layer you created by copying this layer to and copying the layer mask. Okay, so reactivate it, and now we add an adjustment layer to this layer here by pressing on the hue saturation layer. So adjustment layer, and we want to clip this adjustment layer only to the upper layer. So you press the Alt key on your keyboard and move your cursor or your mouse cursor over this horizontal line, and you just can see it changes. And if I click, I clip the adjustment layer only to this layer. So this restricts the adjustment layer only to the one layer beneath it. Next, you pull down the saturation to an amount of minus 40 or minus 30, and then I pull down the lightness to minus 40, or a value that fits to your image. So that's it for this tutorial, and that's how you create realistic tattoos in Photoshop. Don't forget to like this clip and subscribe to our channel for new tutorials every week. If you want to, you can visit our Facebook site, here's the link, or you can visit our website on tigerfishtutorials.com. My name, as always, is Kurt Elsner, and thank you for watching, and hope to see you soon. Bye bye.